Today, I'm going to show you how to install the 9-bar OPV mod on your Gadget Classic Pro. So this video will be one in a series of videos dedicated to showing you how to make the most of your brand new Gadget Classic Pro, from steaming to dialing in to upgrades and mods. All of the gear I use will be linked in the description down below alongside the other Gadget Classic Pro videos. One of the reasons why this machine is so popular is because of its moddability. There's an entire community of people who are creating mods to help get the most out of this budget machine, and one of those popular mods is the 9-bar OPV mod. Out of the factory, this machine's pressure is set way higher than the industry standard of 9 bars. I think it's somewhere in the range of 13 to 15. So this is a very quick and easy mod that will change your pressure down to the standardized 9 bars, and in my experience, this not only helps significantly with both channeling and spurting issues, but can even help with giving you an easier time to dial in shots. I do want to leave a disclaimer here that doing this may void your warranty, and I take no responsibility if you damage your machine or injure yourself, so take caution. So I purchased this 9-bar OPV mod kit by Mr. Shades Coffee. The mod is super simple, as it's basically just a little spring swap. The only things you'll need for this mod is a small screwdriver and a 10mm wrench. I also suggest that you do this mod with an empty boiler and water reservoir, and obviously unplug your machine. So the first thing you're going to want to do is to unscrew these two screws on the top of the machine. You don't have to unscrew it all the way, just enough for it to get loose so that you can lift and pull back the top piece. Underneath this top tray, you'll see a cone shape, and that's for filling up the water reservoir from the top, as well as two wires. You can unplug these easily, but I kinda just let mine dangle off the side while doing this mod. The next thing you're going to want to do is to locate this little white tube connecting to the pump. Now, a quick disclaimer here that not all Gadget models look the same inside, and the Mr. Shades Coffee website does have guides to tell you what to do differently if you have an older model machine. This is the newest model currently available, purchased in January 2021. Okay, so the next thing you're going to want to do is pull out this little white tube connecting to the pump. It's pretty tight and a little tricky to do carefully. I kind of wiggled it mine back and forth while pulling on it till it popped off. Next, you'll need a 10mm wrench. And when I say 10mm, I mean 10mm. Back when I had my original Gadget nearly a year ago and did this mod the first time, I had a 9mm, 11mm, and an adjustable one, but none of them really worked, and I actually ended up breaking part of the pump and had to order a new one. So be very careful, and please use a 10mm wrench. Carefully unscrew and loosen the brass nut here, and you will notice that it really only moves in one direction to loosen it. So if you feel any resistance, stop applying pressure immediately. Unscrew that till it's loose enough to take it off with your finger. Once you take the brass nut off, you'll see the spring. Now we can set that aside and replace it with the 9-bar spring from our kit. The kit also does come with lower pressure springs if you're into that, but I'm going to be using the 9-bar one here. Now all you have to do is work backwards. Retighten the brass nut. Again, you'll feel a hard stop point when it's done. Push the white tube back in carefully, slide in the top panel and reconnect the wires if you took them out, and screw the top panel back down. And there you go. This is a super quick and easy mod, and the results are really night and day. Since installing this mod, shots no longer spurt like crazy, and dialing in beans have become a lot easier. Now, keep in mind that the process may be different depending on the exact model of your machine, but again, go check the Mr. Shades Coffee website, and he's very helpful in helping you find exactly what you need. As a reminder, links to everything featured are available in the description down below, as well as my other Gadget Classic Pro related videos. So, as always, thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it or found it useful, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more coffee content. And I will see you in the next one.